A signal generator can be a useful tool when configuring, tuning, or troubleshooting a sound system. The DCI Network Series amps have a built-in signal and noise generator that can be configured with the Audio Architect software. To access the signal generator, open up the amplifier's default device panel by double-clicking on the amplifier. Towards the top of the main panel, double-click on the signal generator button to open up the signal generator configuration window. First, select the type of signal you wish to generate. There are three different types of signal generations to choose from: white noise, pink noise, and sine wave. If choosing a sine wave, set the frequency. Next, turn the signal generator on by clicking the on-off button at the top. There are two different sets of gain faders for the signal generator. The first is a master fader, which feeds into the second, the channel faders. Set the master fader as desired. Right now, the signal generator is enabled and outputting signal to the individual channel faders. At this point, the channel faders are set to negative 100 dB, so you will not notice any signal on the outputs. Next, raise the channel faders until you have reached a desired signal level. If you wish to independently control the signal level to each amp channel, click on the area to the left of the channel faders to bring up the individual channel faders window. In this window, each channel fader can be independently configured. In certain specific applications, you may want to alter the characteristics of the signal generated by the signal generator. For these rare instances, the DCI Network amps offer four independent filters. Each filter can be configured in the exact same manner as the input and output EQ sections. You can change the filter type, frequency, gain, Q, and slope. Note that when you make changes while online, the amplifier will immediately reflect the changes you are making on screen. Take care not to damage any speaker drivers. Thank you for watching this video. For questions, comments, or suggestions regarding this or any other video, please send them to the email address shown below. For technical assistance, please call the technical support department or email them at the options shown below.